Hi, my name is Ray, and I'm a student of the Masters of Natural Science Education program at Colorado State University. The program is designed to take scientific concepts and how teachers can teach those scientific concepts in the classroom. And so one of the concepts that we learn is spectroscopy. I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you how to build a spectrometer for less than 10 bucks. And I know some devices on the market cost upwards of $300. The concept of spectroscopy ultimately is how do particles and solutions interact with light. Now, light is a very complicated concept for a lot of teachers and ultimately for students as well. So one great way to illustrate this is actually working with the spectrometer device and seeing what happens or what is the resulting light after it passes through a solution. So here are all the supplies that we're going to use to build our device. I have a VHS case here, which is essentially going to house the device, a USB webcam, which is going to, of course, just hooks up to any sort of computer. That's what's going to capture and read our images for us. I have a piece of cardstock here, and then a DVD-R, which is going to do the diffracting of the light for us into the webcam. A couple of cutting supplies is all you need to put this together. So the first part here is we're just going to cut a slit in the side of this VHS case where the light will enter into our system right here. So we're going to cut this guy out. Should pop right out. Now this cut doesn't have to be precise, just some sort of opening for the light to come through. I'll show you where the precise cut needs to come into play. The next piece is to take the cardstock. Now you want to make sure your cardstock is cut down so that way it fits inside of your VHS box. And then you're going to take the edge of the cardstock and you're going to fold it up about an inch, fits along the side of the VHS box or whatever, you know, housing mechanism you are using. This is the only cut that needs to be really precise. It's done with an X-Acto knife just to help with the precision of this, but you want the slit to be about a millimeter in width. It's kind of cut up on this edge that we have folded up already. And as I put this cardstock into our device, we can see here that that slit does in fact match up with the big cut that we made in our VHS container. We're gonna use a DVD-R, and this is ultimately what's gonna diffract the light that's going into the webcam. So what I've done is I've just cut like a little pie out of the DVD-R here, and what you're gonna do is carefully try and split the DVD-R. And so what we're gonna see here is this half with the shiny stuff on, we're no longer gonna need this half here. But this part right here, it's kind of like had a purpley tint to it. This is the diffracting grating. And so this is what we're gonna use to actually separate the light as it enters our webcam. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my webcam here and we're gonna cut down this DVD-R piece so that way it fits right over the lens of the webcam. Now the only thing that you wanna keep track of is where the rounded edge of your DVD-R is. We wanna make sure that that runs essentially perpendicular up and down with our webcam. So I'm just gonna cut a little square out of this so that way it fits right over the webcam. So all that's left now is to essentially just tape everything into our device. So I'm gonna take the cardstock that we cut out, making sure my slit lines up with my opening. I have a couple pieces of tape on there and I'm just gonna tape it in. Now, we can see that this is the slit where the light is going to enter. So we wanna position our webcam so that way it will capture the light at a 45 degree angle. It doesn't have to be precise, but just make sure it's in the ballpark and then we're gonna tape our webcam down. Here's my device that I've created in the past. So this is ultimately what the end product looks like. We have our slit cut through, and then you can see that it's at a 45 degree angle into my webcam. So for the experiment portion of the lab, all I have here is a white LED. And then what I did is I actually took binder dividers and I cut them up into 1-inch squares to represent various transparent colors. So I have here yellow, purples, orange and red, blue and green. So we have our completed device. Really, that's all that's left is to plug it in and do some experiments. So what I'm doing here is I've just had my USB device hooked up to some online spectral analysis tool. There's several of them that are available online. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna show you a demonstration that kind of helps illustrate the concept of color. The whitey LED emits a continuous spectrum, so we can see that we can have a spectrum that's composed of blues and some greens and some reds. And what I'm gonna do to kind of help illustrate the point of color is I have a green transparent film here. And I'm gonna set the green transparent film in between the light and our device. And so what we can see here is that the green film kind of knocks out some of the red colors that are coming through. We can still illustrate this further by let's take a red transparent film. Block it with that, and now we can see only the red part of the spectrum is coming through, whereas before the green and the blue were coming through as well. So this is a great way to illustrate the concept of light and how it relates to various wavelengths. A simple device like this can take an abstract concept like color that's often difficult for students to understand, make it very visual and concrete for them. Now this device, of course, can do a lot more than that. We can look at things like absorbance and transmittance of various solutions and chemicals. We could take a look at Beer's law and how transmittance and intensity relates to concentration. There are tons of things that you can do with this very simple $10 device.